Dragonstars, one of the most highly criticized yet highly affordable lines that any Dragon Ball figure line has ever seen. With the recent criticism that has come with the Ultra Instinct Goku and some other figures that came out in this line, Dragonstars has been getting a lot of criticism from fans and collectors all over the world. To discuss this, I am joined here today by Dragonell Z Stop Motion.
What's up, everyone? Glad to make it.
And the other guy, who just quite recently, probably a couple months ago, he hit 1,000 subscribers. He has lots of awesome stop motions on his channel and a really good start off series to go on his channel. Please welcome the man, Sayajin Kami. And no, it's not Super Goku 02. He's changed his name to Sayajin Kami. That's who he
hey,
is.
Hey, hey, who said you could bring that up? Like, for real. Thanks for having me on this video.
I'll never let you escape that.
Hey, calm down with that one. All right, let's get this video started.
All right, so Dragonstars. Dragonstars is an American Dragon Ball figure line, which most of you already know if you had clicked on this video to know about this thing. And recently with Dragonstars, they've just been getting a lot of hate with figures like their most recent Ultra Instinct Goku and a whole bunch of stuff, with many people coming out with so much different criticisms about this line and different reasons why they hate it. They have come out and compared this figure line to $20 figures that you can get up like Marvel Legends or even the SH Figure Arts line in general, seeing how the SH Figure Arts line is the other most popular line that is out there. So, Sayajin Kami, would you go over the criticisms real quick of this Dragonstars line?
Main criticisms of the line so far are like a mixture of many different things. Paint deco's a big part. Sculpt is a huge thing as well with certain figures. Recently, people have been complaining about their sculpts, and overall, just the look of the line compared to Figure Arts, as Figure Arts is the main, like, for the past 10 years, has been the main 6-inch scale Dragon Ball line that's been around. It's really been the only one. So for a new line to come in, of course, it's going to be immediately compared to Figure Arts. And also, being that it's the third line in the past 10 years, including Figure Arts Standard, or Figure Arts Standard, it's going to be like kind of in the middle. It's going to be sandwiched between two different lines. Now, I feel like it's kind of like the odd person out, because we have fans of Figure Arts Standard, and we have fans of Figure Arts, and then we have people in the middle for Dragonstars, and it's kind of just torn.
Yeah, and I know a lot of people, when they're talking about the sculpt, it usually has to do most of the time with the hair that is sculpted on figures. Like, for example, so many people have compared the Super Saiyan Rage Trunks head and said that that thing looks like a whole thing of it looks like a bunch of bananas. Exactly.
Yeah, bananas. I'll give that to like most of the head sculpts in Dragonstars. They're odd looking. Like, I feel like the only like there's a couple of good like okay hair sculpts in the line. Like, I'll give it to, like, even though Wave 1 of Dragonstars isn't as good as the rest of the line, I'll give Wave 1 Super Saiyan Goku, even though I don't have that figure, I have the clone Goku, it's basically the same figure. The hair sculpt on here is actually relatively nice. Same with the Super Saiyan Blue Goku, it's just that the faces for Blue Goku is kind of just off. It's just off faces.
Yeah, the faces kind of throw it off.
I feel like another thing that they always criticize about is comparing the promo pics to the actual in-hand figures that we get. Where, for example, one of the most highly talked about promo image comparisons is the Resurrection F Super Saiyan Blue Goku. On that figure, in the promo images, you saw his hair be all spiky and it would look really cool when you have it, when you look at the promo images. The hair itself looks phenomenal in the promo image and can definitely be said that if that is what we got in hands, it could be the best Super Saiyan Blue Goku hair sculpt that we've received from any figure line, not including what has shown up for pre-orders from Figure Arts. But if they had released that Super Saiyan Blue Goku the way that they showed it off in the promo images, it would probably be the best Super Saiyan Blue Goku hair sculpt in the actual line as of right now.
Yeah.
But the issue is that I feel Dragonstars really struggles with the hair is they have to go, because the figures are marketed towards ages 4 and up type people, they have to go and they have to round out the hairs and make it so that it's not sharp and people go poke each other to death with this with this hair sculpt. And that's why so many people have that issue with the line, is that it's because it's 4 and up, they have to do that. And I've even seen people go and say that Marvel Legends, they don't even do that. But the thing is, Marvel Legends does do that. If you look at the Wolverine figure from Marvel Legends, one of the best figures that people have ranked that as one of the best figures. If you look at the claws, they may be sharp, they may be like pokey, but they're not so sharp. They rounded those edges to make sure that children do not hurt themselves when handling this figure. They do the exact same thing in Marvel Legends. Anything that has a pokiness, they go out and round out the edge to make sure that nothing
as noticeable for Marvel Legends, because it's not like with Dragon Ball where characters' hair are so stylized and spiked up that it's more obvious when you see it on a Dragon Ball figure compared to a Marvel Legend, because Marvel Legends figures, really the only sharp areas would probably be like weapons or parts of their costume. While Dragon Ball figures, it's their hair. Like with the Kale Build-A-Figure, the promo images, the hair sculpt looked absolutely amazing. It was perfectly like one-to-one with the show. It was perfectly spiky. But when it was released, the Build-A-Figure piece came out, the hair, every single piece of the hair was rounded off. And it doesn't look as good, of course it's not, and it's gonna look slightly weird. But there's no way you can really get around that, because either having really, really sharp hair that will have people complain about to the company having kids play with this, or rounding off the edges and not even having to worry about complaints from parent groups, or just having complaints from collectors. It's like either one. It's like a trade-off.
One of the things that I've talked about with D&Z in the past, whenever we talked about these figure lines like Dragonstars, we always went back into the old days and we talked about the Irwin Toys figures. So D&Z, let me know what you think when you compare the Dragonstars to the Irwin Toys figures, and why they are in fact the essential childhood figures of this day and age.
Well, you see, when I compare Dragonstars to Irwin Toys figures back in the past, and like, you know, Jack's figures, I feel like they are the childish figures of nowadays, because this is the main, like Americanized Dragon Ball toy line, but like in America nowadays, so, I mean, it's kind of like the first one that's like really, you know, happened in like a few years, so, I feel like you can compare and contrast the lines by the figures, you know, the sculpt, articulation, all that, but I feel like, in terms of like which one is better, Dragonstars is ultimately going to beat it out in the end.
To me, Dragonstars is just, it's an okay line. It's not the main line I collect. The only thing, I really only get characters from the Dragonstars line that haven't been released in 6-inch form anywhere else. And I feel like that's really the main drive for this line that's been keeping it afloat, is the fact that they've done characters that Figure Arts hasn't done yet or are about to do that haven't been released yet. I feel like that's something that takes collectors to like collect this line, because if this line was just doing characters that Figure Arts has done multiple different times, people wouldn't really care about the line. And I feel like that's the thing with like dissatisfaction with recent waves and like certain figures in the line. Of course, people aren't going to be interested in it because they have a better version of that character from the line they mainly collect. Like, that's just the main factor. Like, I feel like Dragonstars isn't a terrible line. It's a good line for $20 figures that are sold at retail. And of course, they're not going to be compared to, like, Figure Arts at all. But even then, comparing them to other $20 lines like Marvel Legends and stuff, even then, I feel like the comparison, it's justified, but still, this line's only about 3 years old at this point, almost 3 years old, compared to Marvel Legends, who have had like 15 years being on the market, evolving with the times and having ups and downs. So I feel like with a line like this, it only really has potential to get better.
Obviously, their figures are targeted towards the people who can't afford figure arts, but they still have the decent quality that people are looking for. What I think makes this line super important is for the future Dragon Ball fans. For those people who can't afford figure arts, they're still going to be having Dragon Stars is there so that people can still have their Dragon Ball figures to go up on their shelves. When they have like brothers or something like that, say, you know, you have your little brother, they're gonna look at this and they're gonna be like, hey man, what's that figure? And you'd be telling your little brother, oh yeah, that's Goku or Vegeta from Dragon Ball Z. These guys are awesome. And that these kinds of figures, I think, could lead to future fans of the franchise. That's why Dragon Stars, in my opinion, is one of the most important lines, not for Japan, but for American Dragon Ball fans in general. As many problems as there is, that's why I can't help but find the importance of this line. So Dragonell, I know you have been talking, you have been holding in your entire opinion for this video, but you know what? Go ahead and let loose, talk about, say your personal opinions on this line, and address the hate.
All right, I know we've already kind of covered the whole thing with the age gap. I mean, the age group being 4+, and now they're marketed towards kids. Now the price range is a little bit cheaper, and it's just, it kind of annoys me how like some people, like, they always, whenever we get a new Dragon Stars, they always like compare it to figure arts, and it makes really like no sense to me, because the Dragon Stars line is never going to be as good or even close to good as good as figure arts, because you're talking about like figures who range from like $20 to $25 compared to figures that usually rank from, I don't know, like $70-$60. Like you're never gonna get the same quality regardless of how good the Dragon Stars figure is. You could take the best Dragon Stars figure out that's out right now, and you can take the worst figure arts figure that's currently out right now, and you still won't be able to like compare the two. And I feel like you should get like Dragon Stars a little bit of you know, props, because as Sayajin Kami was saying, like with the whole thing with the characters, we do have more characters and like in this line that we don't see in figure arts and probably will never see in figure arts, like Super Saiyan 4 Goku that's coming out soon. You know, we're gonna get that, and you know, I know we like had seen some images of it like in the past from figure arts, but that was like 4 years ago. We're probably not gonna even get it, as well as some other figures that we've seen like in the promo images from figure arts. Like I have the Dragon Stars Jiren and Hit, and they're not perfect figures, but they're still they hold the gap in there till I get, you know, something better, or until, you know, just to hold me over, or, you know, they may not release a Jiren or Hit in figure arts, you know, we don't know. So the Dragon Stars line is very important, as you were saying.
We do actually have promo images of a Jiren. It is teased that they're going to release it sometime in 2019. I just wanted to correct you on that.
Yeah, no, I noticed that. I said it. Yeah, we do have images of Jiren coming in, but as far as Hit and some of the other figures that we're going to get in Dragon Stars, as far as figures that we already have in Dragon Stars, there's no telling for if we're going to get to see those figures in figure arts in the future. And if we do, it's probably going to be like a year from now, or even longer.
And even if
you can never know.
And even if you did get, and even if figure arts did later release a Hit, for example, obviously they're going to release a Jiren. Even if they do release the figures that Dragon Stars people are considering placeholders for, who's to say that you're actually going to go out and be able to afford this kind of thing? That's what makes Dragon Stars so unique. It's an affordable figure line, and the whole build-a-figure thing, you're getting more for your buck. You're not getting as much quality, but
getting
I think
more bang for your buck.
I feel like people are getting enough satisfaction if they're not looking for super high quality figures. It all depends on your personal preference, and if Dragon Stars works out for you, then absolutely more power to you. Me personally, I've always had my issues with Dragon Stars. I'm usually like this, where I'm skeptical about certain figures. Obviously, with things like articulation being a big factor, we don't get a lot of head movement on Dragon Stars, and we don't get a lot of torso articulation. But that won't change just how much Dragonstars is special to so many people, even as, because even when compared to older Dragon Ball figures that people would get, like Jack Stowe, from Irwin Toys and things like that, obviously Dragonstars is in a much higher quality and is in the price range for those things. And I think if we were to really look at it from a certain perspective, the Irwin Toys of yesterday is Dragonstars today in a whole nother form.
Exactly.
Like, I just feel like with Dragonstars, it's not just the fact that they're cheap. It's not just that. It's just that it has a variety that any other line currently doesn't really have in this scale. So I feel like as a line that's still really early in its infancy, I'm not really mad at the mistakes they do. Like, I want them to get better, obviously. And obviously, figures have had problems in these waves every single wave, of course. But if I see them obviously improving, even though this current wave, the Broly wave that we've been talking about, is kind of like the weakest wave of the line, it's kind of the worst wave of the line, I still see hope with the next wave, how much potential they have to keep going forward. The Build-A-Figure whole thing with that is one of the most interesting things about this, because it offers a way to get certain figures that we've never seen in 6-inch scale and probably won't see for a while in figure arts form, like Merge Zamasu and Kale, stuff like that. Even though we might see versions of those in figure arts, it's going to be a while. And for that time, those are really great versions of these characters in 6-inch form, where you'll find them nowhere else.
Yeah, and listen.
Yeah, another thing.
Oh, sorry. Listen, I don't know if you're probably gonna say the exact same thing as me, but I'm gonna just say it right now, D&Z. Dragonstars, you're absolutely not gonna see this video, but if you want to be able to get more of a market from other collectors, and you want to be able to extend your reaches, I think you would really benefit if you started making GT figures. Imagine a whole Dragon Ball GT line in the form of Dragonstars. You could have obviously we have Super Saiyan 4 Goku, so it's definitely not out of reach. Imagine if we can get a Dragonstars Kid Goku, Pan, Trunks, Vegeta.
Oh my gosh, my heart is racing just hearing that.
Goten. All of these kinds of things. Obviously, GT isn't the most well-received series, but I think a lot of people would love to have GT figures. Because good or bad, GT was a childhood show for all of us. And even as we talk about GT, people love GT, people hate it. It is still one of the most important things to our childhood and should definitely be respected for what it did at that time. And you know, who wants to build a figure Omega Shenron? I know I'm not the only one who wouldn't want to build a figure Omega Shenron.
Oh my gosh, I would love that. I would literally
Shadow Dragon, wait, Super 17, baby Vegeta.
Low-key, I wouldn't want it to be a Build-A-Figure because, yeah, I'm not trying to buy a whole wave of Dragonstars.
Well, I mean, yeah, but, you know, like, what if the figures are good?
I only really buy Dragonstars of figures that I don't have in figure arts form. So it depends on if they did a wave that has Omega Shenron in it. It depends on if the whole wave is figures that haven't been released in figure arts form. That's the only thing.
I feel like
a Dragon Ball GT line, as you said, Ish, will be like really important to Dragonstars, because let's be honest, we're probably not going to get a whole line of GT figures in figure arts form, let alone even just one of Super Saiyan 4 Goku. So I feel like, as you said, like if you were going to buy the whole wave, I feel like it would be, you know, kind of worth it, because we're probably not going to see any of those figures in, you know, in figure arts form anytime soon. No. And if we do, it's going to be a while. So I feel like depending on the characters that they decide to make, like in the GT line, third wave, I feel like, you know, we'd be more prone to buy.
All right. I think I think we've pretty much gone over all the points of this video. Is there anything you guys want to go over before we end, before we wrap this stuff up?
Well, again, going back to the complainers, you know, people who constantly compare the Dragonstars to figure arts, like, they don't really, I feel like they want to crap all over Dragonstars, and they just do it, obviously, because of the, you know, the flaws it has, but they don't really take the time to really, like notice why the figures are the way they are. And they just over the past like 3 years, almost 3 years, the line's been out. They have improved like greatly between like the wave that's out currently, or more so the last wave, and comparing it to the wave one, it's like, you know, night and day, as you said, Shaheen.
The last thing I really have to say is just like with a line that's still just like it hasn't hit 10 waves yet. And yes, there's a lot of figures in the line so far, but as I see the future with the next wave, how good it actually looks, like a lot of the figures, even figures that I already have figure arts versions of, they look good in the new wave. Like First Form Frieza, even though there's not a version of him out there, he looks dope. He looks really good. There's certain things I'd fix on him, but overall, he looks fine. Same with Super Saiyan 4 Goku. Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks that figure arts didn't give a head for. Stuff like that. All these things, they look fine to me. And they look like the future of this line is going to be really good. And as it keeps going on, I just hope it keeps improving. And this new wave gives me hope, even though the current wave we have is kind of just... it's a trash wave, I'll be completely honest. It's not a really good wave. It's a peck holder wave. It gives me hope for the rest of the line that we keep getting new stuff like this. This is one step to a better line overall. So I wouldn't completely shit.
Yeah, so guys, you gotta grab your shades because the future of Dragonstars is bright.
All right. Thank you guys so much for joining. If you like this video, you already know what to do to the videos that you like. Thank you, DragonLZ and Sayajin Kami, for joining us on this video. I hope you guys have a great day. This has been Starblast Studios, Sayajin Kami, and DragonLZ, and we'll see you guys in the comments section. Until then.
See ya.
Peace.